Hey, what's up, YouTube? Welcome to Sixx Days. I am Bob Sixx, and today I'm doing one of those mixed up quadruple shots. This one's got Black Label Society, In This River, Machine Gun Kelly, All I Know, Asking Alexandria, Moving On, and Ghostmane, Lazaretto. I hope I'm saying that right. If I'm not, I'm sure somebody will correct me. Before we go any farther, I'm excited. I got the prototype for my first shirt. I'm waiting on now for estimates so that I can get the best quality shirt for the lowest price. If you're interested, make sure you make a comment or let me know. And if you're not, don't say anything. If you're new to the channel, it's what I do. Real, genuine, unbiased reactions. I promise I'll never say that I like or act like I like something I don't. Takes a little getting used to. That's enough of that. Let's get into this. Black Label Society, In This River.
Are you ready, Dan?
I don't know, Zach. I'm kind of scared.
Me too.
Let's do it.
Losing friends as you get older, your thinking gets easier, but it doesn't. Several of my childhood friends died over the years. I didn't have to experience that. I just found out later, and I was like, oh, that's sad because they were such a good person. I probably did a lot of things in life that should have terminated my existence, from drug addiction to alcoholism, which literally almost did. I was told when I was 27, 28 years old, if I didn't stop drinking, I wouldn't see my 32nd birthday. Scared me for a little while. I didn't stop until I decided it was time. And that's the key with any addiction. You have to want to stop. So when I see somebody that's lived my life, the style, the way that I have, still alive and healthy to the best of my knowledge, and some good people that just fucking died, that sucks for a whole host of reasons. You know, a little over a year ago, my best friend died. That caught me off guard. It made me cry uncontrollably for a while, and I'm not a crier. But when my father passed away, and he was a good man, didn't smoke, very rarely drank, to watch him just get Parkinson's disease and wither away for 2 years, suffer the way he did, and never give up fighting and hope that he would recover. And then once he did accept his fate, well, long after that, before he died. I don't know, it's bizarre.
Also afraid to bear in this river.
So, my reaction may be kind of confusing because technically, as far as structure, composition, it's not the strongest song. However, emotionally, everything falls into place because the video, even though it was showing a scenario, I'm guessing a childhood friend died, and he's carried guilt about that, which I can see how that would mess you up. The song is not specific enough to tie it into one thing. So it emotionally can work for whatever scenario, whatever burden you're carrying. It doesn't have to be death. It could be that you fucked someone over at some point in life, or regrets that you didn't take a chance to try something when you had the opportunity. Because the river is life. Happiness, sadness, death, it's all in it. At least that's my take. And so that way, it struck me emotionally because I kept thinking about people that in my life that I've lost. So that way is a really good song. So that's an interesting thing for me, that the song itself was not that strong as far as composition goes, like I said, but it evokes that emotion from you and makes you think about shit. So I really, really like that. Great thing to have happen to you.
All I know is I don't know nothing. All I know is I don't know nothing at all. People talk but they don't say nothing. All I know is I don't know nothing at all. No license, I'm still riding. Crashed into a tree and kept driving. My label hates that I'm like this. I gotta go through shit to keep writing. All these girls, I don't want none of them. But I know I'll end up with one of them. My life on the outside's fun of them. But the person on the inside is crumbling. All I know is I don't know nothing. All I know is I don't.
I've made that face in that situation. Now, the last time I was arrested, 22 years ago? I think, wait, no. 18 years ago. No. Oh, shit. Way longer ago than I was thinking. 28 years ago. Holy shit, that was a long time ago. I assure you, I did not have that look on my face. I was extremely angry because I wasn't drunk. I was legally drunk, but not drunk. And he pulled me over a little over two blocks from my house. I could literally see my girlfriend, who's now my wife, standing there watching me be arrested. And he arrested me because he didn't like my attitude, because I cussed at him, because he was bored, living in a small town, and he pulled me over because I was chasing that car. And even though I pointed and told him that that was my girlfriend, and that's the much censored version of it, he didn't like the way I was talking to him. He really didn't like the fact I passed the field sobriety test, so he arrested, well, took me to jail, then arrested me. But as a kid, once I knew I was busted, because I didn't half-heartedly do anything. If I made a commitment to do something wrong, I did it. And if I got caught, I got caught. I mean, I tried to lie my way out of it first, but usually I just, yeah, I did it. Let's move on. It's the quickest way to get through it. For me, anyways.
Oh no, nothing at all. People talk, but they don't say nothing. All I know is I don't know nothing at all. All I know is I don't know nothing. I love you, but I don't love nothing at all. Yeah, the world is crazy, so corrupted. I'm by myself, so I don't feel too involved. Cause I'm alone, alone, all alone. Don't know who to call, I don't know what I know. If you know the answer to these things, let me know. Let me know, let me know again. All I know is I don't know.
Wow. I know I just stopped it, but I gotta stop again. I wasn't sure how Trippie Red was going to do into this. You know, I knew he was a feature in it, but I had no idea. Damn. I thought he did outstanding. It doesn't seem out of place. Fits in quite nicely. You know, it's not like when you do a peep, when I do peep reactions and he has features, the features almost always suck. It's very rare that you go, oh, well, that's a nice mix. 95, 96, 97, 98% of the time, the features suck. There's the train. It's like they know when I'm shooting videos and they come through. But stronger artists always bring in strong features. I mean, not saying that Peep wasn't strong, saying he felt bad for his friends that were less talented and he put them on. These guys are bringing in strong features, and I dig the shit out of it.
Nothing. All I know is I don't know nothing at all. People talk, but they don't say nothing. All I know is I don't know nothing at all. Red chains, I've been running from the cops all night. I'm dead, I don't care about nothing. Bloody tape in my mouth when I smiled last night. Broke his jaw, now he can't say nothing.
I know I say it every time, but I am really digging this new music that Machine Gun Kelly's putting out. I think it suits him much, much better. It's fun, even when he's talking about not fun shit. The music's fun. It's got a good beat to it. He said something in that song that's extremely important, and I realized it a long time ago. Even though I'm a nerd and I try to know everything about everything, or a little about everything, not everything about everything, a little about everything, I'm still smart enough to know, in the grand scheme of it, I don't know anything. So until you realize that you're not the smartest person in the room, or accept the fact that you're not, or you may not be the smartest person in the room, you got a lot of hard road ahead of you. All right, man, I know this is a long video. Asking Alexandria. Moving on. God damn. Love the vibe of this song. And it's only a minute and 14 seconds in, and he said something that is extremely important for you to remember in life. Once you reach to the point of you don't want to do this anymore, stop and move on. People were stunned when I stopped performing stand-up. I wasn't failing. I wasn't struggling. My gut told me. I wasn't on stage. I was away from it. But for a week, maybe a little bit longer, I just, in my gut, it told me to stop. So I did. And it wasn't subtle. I just fucking quit. I didn't tell anybody, like, I got two shows left or one show left. My gut said quit. I made sure that's what felt right. And I quit and I've moved on. Now y'all get most of my time. Wanted to change the world to make it all worthwhile. So we put his pen to paper and pull out everything inside. It's what I said enough at the moment the day it became. Slowly but surely on the fast track to falling into his grave. Guarantee this is one of those songs. It's a great song, but somebody who has told me it's some shitty song is a great song and I don't know what I'm talking about and I don't know music, they're going to hear this and they're going to say, now that song sucks, see, you don't know what you're talking about. No, I do know. Plus, bottom line is, it's my opinion and your opinion of the shitty song. That's all it is. It's our opinions. But I am digging the shit out of this song. Will definitely be on my playlist in my car. Definitely. Boy of anguish, now he's a man of soul. Traded in his misery for the lonely life of the road. And now y'all actually know that I was enjoying the song, because the people who've been around a while know that I constantly check the time if I don't like a song, and I actually interrupted that right before it was over, so I had no idea where I was at. But love, love, love that song. Hopefully Ghostmane will bring it too. A lot of people have been asking for this one. Lazaretto. Holy shit, I love that one. That song will definitely become part of my morning playlist. Tuesday through Friday, when I work my other job that doesn't start as early as my job, Saturday through Monday, I have a playlist of songs I listen to that get me amped up, in the mood, feeling creative. This will be on that list in the morning. I fucking love that song. Even though it kind of reminds me of Slipknot, I'm okay with Slipknot. I like some of their music, but I'm not a huge fan. That song's badass. No wonder it has so many views, and so many of you have been asking me to do it. So, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Alright, I thought this video went well. We went through a whole gamut of types of music, getting in all sorts of emotions and feelings. Wow, I hope y'all enjoy it as much as I have. Thank you for hanging out. Have a great day. Make someone laugh if you get the chance. Don't forget to tell your friends and family each and every time you leave that you love them, because you just never know when that's going to be the last chance you get to tell them. Stay safe, people. We are living in some crazy ass times. I am Bob Sixx. Peace.